All right, so I just finished the 2018 TV miniseries for Watership Down. Now, if you're not already aware, this TV series is based off the book written by Richard Adams. There's also a 1978 movie adaptation as well. And I find it very convenient that this TV series came out this year because literally just a few months ago, I finished the book. The only reason I wanted to read it was because, one, I saw a Lost episode where Sawyer was reading it on the island, and I wanted to know what the symbolism behind that was. And for the record, I definitely understand that symbolism now. And also, I love collecting the Criterion movies, and I noticed that Watership Down was one of the titles in the Criterion collection. And so before watching the movie, I wanted to read the book. And I thoroughly enjoyed this book. And so you can imagine that as I was reading it, when I found out that there was going to be a TV series coming out at the end of the year, I was pretty excited. I would say my expectations were pretty high until I saw the first trailer and I saw that animation. I'm not a big fan of the animation. I haven't really heard of anyone who is a fake fan of this animation, but I'll get to that more later. But to give a brief general review, I enjoyed it. I thought it was pretty good. There were some pros and some cons. Let's talk about both. A pro was the voice acting. The cast is all very famous people. We've got James McAvoy, John Boyega, Nicholas Holt, Ben Kingsley. I mean, it is an all-star cast for crying out loud, and that worked very well for this series. I think all the voice acting was very fitting for each character, especially Ben Kingsley as General Woundwort and James McAvoy as Hazel. I think those were two very well casted choices. Another thing I really liked about this adaptation was the interpretation of Fiverr's visions that he has. The 1978 movie addresses this, but I feel like this TV series went into more depth as to what exactly he's seeing in the visions, and it shows his visions happen more frequently than it did in the movie. And then in the last episode, when Hazel is just about to meet the Black Rabbit of Inlay, Fiverr comes up to him and gives a really heartfelt goodbye, just says, "I've loved you as a leader, I've loved you as a brother, I've loved you as a friend." And I thought that was a really well done implication that Fiverr most likely had a vision that Hazel would die, and so he wanted to say one last goodbye to his brother. I thought that was really neat. Let's talk about a few things that bother me now. Obviously, I'm not adding anything new to the table. The animation is horrible. Like, seriously, guys, the dog looked terrible. When the rabbits move in some scenes, it looked terrible. When they're chewing on rope or anything like that, it's very weird to watch. And also, the humans, wow, the humans looked awful. It reminded me of, like, humans that would be in a Barbie movie. You know what I'm talking about? Like, Barbie Princess and the Pauper? You know, you've seen that. Come on, you've seen it. But it also reminded me of that one Peter Rabbit TV show that aired on Nickelodeon. The animation isn't quite that bad. It is more realistic than that. But it was very similar. But with that being said, I also watched nearly 3.5 hours of rabbits talking, and so I guess the animation wasn't as bad as it could have been, but it definitely wasn't good. And then a few other problems I had are pretty nitpicky. I mean, these are problems that anyone has when it's a book to movie adaptation, or in this case, a book to TV series adaptation. Towards the end of the book, when General Woundwort and his Effervin patrol rabbits are attacking Hazel, Fiverr, Bigwig, and their whole clan, there's a part where it's when Hazel is off in the farm trying to release the dog, and Bigwig stands his ground and he basically says, "I guard this burrow for my chief rabbit." And it's a huge shocker for General Woundwort, because this whole time he has thought that Bigwig is the chief rabbit. And so when he hears that, he's instantly kind of nervous, and he finds out that Bigwig's not the chief rabbit. And so he's wondering, okay, who is the chief rabbit? I didn't really like the way things rolled out with this scene in the TV series. I feel like when I was reading the book, it was a moment where I put the book down for a minute and just, like, I don't know if I said it out loud or if I said it in my head, but either way, I was just like, get wrecked, General Woundwort. Like, he's not the chief rabbit. This is sick. It was a drop the mic moment. Like, to me, it's the equivalent of when Voldemort first sees Harry Potter's alive in the 7th movie, or when President Snow is outsmarted by Katniss Everdeen, or even when Cillian Murphy finds out that his dad truly loves him in Inception. Like, there wasn't any drop the mic moment. It was kind of like Bigwig said it, and then Woundwort just kind of stands there, and then it's his bodyguard that says something. I didn't want that. I wanted it to be more of a drop the mic scene. Also, when Bigwig leads the does out of Effrava and he's going to meet Hazel and the rest of them at the boat, that is a very suspenseful scene in the book. It's a very narrow escape where General Woundwort and his men almost capture Bigwig and the rest of the rabbits, but just by a hair, no pun intended, they get away. This scene was completely cut out of the TV show, and it's not a big complaint because they did have other action filler scenes which were well done, but I really like this scene especially because it's a very suspenseful moment in the book. And then another thing that I didn't really care for was the choice of making Strawberry a girl. The whole point of Watership Down, I mean, besides the initial escape from their burrow, is to find does so that they can survive and repopulate. If they have a doe already in the colony, it being Strawberry, then what's the point of finding more does? Because you can just make bunnies with that doe, and then more does will be born, and you guys get the idea. I don't need to explain this. And so it's just kind of a contradictory change to the plot, to the story. Overall, guys, it was an enjoyable TV show. Like, I guess I'm happy that it happened, but I just wish that a little bit more effort would have gone into the animation. I wish they would have changed a few of the gripes that I had with the story elements. I give the TV show a 7 out of 10. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to hit that subscribe button and leave your comments on what you thought of Watership Down. And you have a great day.